Now let us consider the concept of beats. So what is this beats? When two sound notes of nearly equal frequencies traveling in the same direction superpose on each other. So two sound notes traveling in the same direction having frequencies very close to each other, nearly same frequencies, are traveling in the same direction, superimpose or interfere with each other, then the phenomena in which waxing and waning of sounds takes place is called beats. So when two sound waves are moving in the same direction, they are superposing with each other or interfere with each other, and at regular intervals of time it is possible to hear maximum and minimum sounds waxing and waning. This phenomena is called beats. So in beats it is possible to hear a maximum and minimum sound. One maximum is immediately followed by one minimum. Again maximum, so again minimum. So at regular intervals of time this is possible. So maximum, this is because of waxing of sound, increase in intensity. Minimum, this is waning of sounds. So waxing and waning of sounds at regular intervals of time when two sound notes of nearly equal frequencies traveling in the same direction interfere with each other results beats. One beat, one maximum and one minimum together is called one beat. This is one beat, this is second beat. So if I say beat frequency is n, that means per second you can hear n number of maximum sounds and n number of minimum sounds. Because maximum and minimum is called one beat, and if I say beat frequency is n, so it is possible to hear n maximas and n minimas per second. Suppose if I consider n1 and n2 are the frequencies of the two notes, sound notes, they have frequencies n1 and n2, then beat frequency is given by delta n is equal to n1 difference n2. So from the higher one subtract the second one. The difference in frequencies of the two notes is equal to beat frequency. So what is the time interval between two successive beats? Or simply I can say, what is the time interval between two maximas or two minimas? Whatever you take, whether it is time interval between beats or time interval between two maximas or time interval between two minimas, it is 1 by delta n seconds. So this is said to be the time interval between beats or two maximas or two minimas. Suppose if you take one maximum and one minimum, so one maximum, one minimum, then what is the possible time interval between these two? So half of this value, that is 1 by 2 delta n. The time interval between a maximum and next minimum is 1 by 2 delta n. Since it is time interval between two maximas is 1 by delta n, and in between two maximas one minima occurs. See, this is one maximum, this is another maximum, in between one minimum is present. In between these two, I am saying delta n, 1 by delta n is time period. So in between these two, it becomes 1 by 2 delta n. So it is just because of the interference of the sound waves. Beats is the phenomena due to interference. Condition, the two sound notes must travel in the same direction and the difference must be small. So why we are taking difference must be small? In human ear, the persistence of sound in any human ear is 0.1 second. So once the sound enters into human ear, it will stay for 0.1 seconds. So if you want to discriminate any two sounds, there must be minimum time interval of 0.1 seconds. That means per second how many different sounds we can notice, the human ear can notice, that is 1 by 0.1, so 10. So maximum beat frequency one can hear is 10, because one maxima, minima, next maxima, next minima. So if the beat frequency delta n is greater than 10, impossible to hear, you can't notice them, impossible to recognize them as different sounds. will feel them as a single sound. So if the beat frequency is less than delta n, delta n is less than 10, possible to recognize. That's why the difference must be the 2, n1 difference must be n2, the maximum value is 10. If it is greater than 10, we cannot recognize them as two different sounds. We will consider them as a single sound. We will say a sound is produced. Right. What are the uses of beats? The first one, used to tune the musical instrument. Tuning of musical instruments. Musical instruments can be tuned using this concept of beats. Similarly, second one, here dangerous gases suppose in mines can be detected, because once the medium changes, the frequency automatically changes by noticing the by change in frequency. If you one hears the beats, then we can recognize some change in the medium is occurring. Also, unknown frequency of the given tuning fork, unknown frequency of the given tuning fork can be measured. And also in cinematography also these beats are used to produce a variety of sounds. This is used.